Edith requested that that song be played right before the service, Sweet Hour of Prayer. That was one of her favorite songs, and so we played that in honor of her today. We've gathered here this morning to honor the life and the memory of Edith Maxey, a dear mother, grandmother, great-grandmother, sister, an aunt, and friend. Let me say on behalf of the family how much they appreciate you, all that you've done for Edith, all you've done for them, the beautiful flowers, and your attendance here today, how much they appreciate that. I know that Edith appreciated everything that everyone did for her over the last several months as she had such a rough time, such a struggle in her life with her heart and with breathing, and she just had a rough time. But you were there. She appreciated all the cards. She told me about the cards people sent her, the visits. But most of all, she appreciated the prayers. And she was a prayer warrior, and she appreciated you praying for her. And I want to pray today and to honor her life as we bow for a word of prayer. Precious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord, for this day. We thank you, Lord, for our dear sister, Edith Maxey. Lord, we pray, Lord, you would comfort this family. Lord, I know that they are grieving and they are hurting, but yet they have peace because they know she's with you. Lord, her suffering is over. Her pain is over. Lord, she's breathing freely. She's walking on streets of gold. And Father, we thank you for that today. I pray, Lord, you would be with Malin and be with Pat. I pray you'd be with Lloyd and you would be with Irene and all the grandchildren, Lord, and great-grandchildren that she loved dearly. I pray, Lord, you would comfort them in a mighty way. I pray, Lord, you would be with David. I pray, Lord, you would strengthen him. Thank you for David and all that he did for Edith over these last 19 years. And I know that he's grieving also, and I pray, Lord, you would comfort him in a mighty way, and thank you for him. We just commit this service to you, Lord. We want to honor and glorify you in all that we say and do. We ask it all in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Now, several years ago, Jenny Wilson, a lady in our church, sang It Is Well With My Soul. And after she sang that, Edith said, I want you to sing that at my funeral. So Jenny's going to come and share that special with us in song.
Thank you. with my soul.
Amen. Wow. Praise the Lord. My name's Pastor Jason, and I got to be Edith's pastor for the last 8 years. But she loved Bobby better than me. There were times when I'd call Edith and we'd have a whole conversation, and she, you know, if you've talked to her, she was like my Aunt Velma. I'd be screaming into the phone. And then I'd say, bye, Edith, I love you. And she'd say, this is not a joke, I love you too, Bobby. She told me so many times that Bobby was going to do her funeral. And she said, well, I'll give you 5 minutes, so get your watch out. Edith was a precious lady. Johnny Fielder just said, as Pastor Patrick and I were walking in here, if anybody's getting to heaven, it's Edith. And it's because when you knew Edith, she was so by the book as far as her dress. She was always dressed to the nines. She always looked wonderful. But none of that is why we know she's in heaven. It's because she trusted in Jesus. Amen. And that changed her life. That changed how she treated people. And she was just a sweet, precious lady. She always knew, or always let you know how she felt, though. Did you know that? She didn't really hold things back, Malin. She told me about y'all. She told me about you, Lloyd. And of course, she talked about David. And she loved to talk about Perry. And I would try to get all these people, you know, clear in my head and who she was talking about. And Pat was such, I just told her, she was such a blessing to help take care and all that she did. To be a wonderful daughter-in-law, and the Lord will honor that, I believe, as we look to Him and trust in Him. But Edith was a precious soul, and I thought of Edith and David together, and David said the only way he could get a girlfriend was by buying a house from her. And so he did that with Edith instead of renting, and the Lord blessed that. And then it was always hearing about Edith and David going out with Frank and Jane and on their adventures together. And as David said to me just a while ago, times are changing. And it pays for us, dear ones, to rely on the Lord. Amen. To look to Him in these difficult times. I don't know what you're going through besides, of course, dealing with the loss of Miss Edith. But really, really, we don't lose her if we know Jesus. There's a temporary loss, but she's in heaven. And she's doing better than she's ever done here before. Did you know that? I mean, she really is. We say that, but we really believe it. She is better than any of us are. And she's just looking to the Lord. Changes your life. The scripture says in John chapter 3 and verse 16, the Lord Jesus had been talked about and his conversation with Nicodemus about being born again. And he says this, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son, his unique son, so that whoever believes in him will not perish, but will have everlasting life. And I believe because Jesus died for Edith, because he raised from the dead, that you can have hope in your hearts, that your mom is in heaven, that she's doing better than she's ever done, and that she's with those that she's loved, that gone on, and there was a great rejoicing when she came into the presence of her Savior. And we thank the Lord for that, and we praise the Lord for the testimony that Miss Edith gave us all. Amen. Amen. Heavenly Father, we do, Lord, we want to praise you and thank you for the life of Edith Maxey. Lord, thank you for her sweet smile. Thank you, Lord, for her love to you, her love for her family. Lord God, just how she continually talked about them. And Lord, I know that there is a great missing piece for this dear family today. And Lord, I do pray for them as Brother Bobby has prayed. And I do, Lord, pray for Brother David, for all the friends, all, Lord, those who are just going to miss talking to Edith. But Lord, remind us that if we are in Christ, that we have something to look forward to with being together again with you. And Lord, for those who are here that don't yet know Jesus, as they hear the message of the gospel, God, I pray you would turn their hearts to you so that they would see their need for a Savior through Jesus Christ. In his name we pray. Amen.
And I think Edith was timing that in heaven, and I think it was 5 minutes. Because many times she would, when he and I would be together, she said, she would tell, remind Jason, she said, now, Bobby's doing my funeral, but you can have 5 minutes.
So, it wasn't any time, Bobby, it was every time.
Every time. Well, when, as I grew up at Barnhart Baptist Church, and Edith was there for many years, and I sang this song as a child there, Till the Storm Passes By, and she always loved that song, and she had asked me to sing this at her funeral today, Till the Storm Passes By. In the dark of the midnight, have I oft hid my face, while the storms howl above me, and there's no hiding place. Mid the crash of the thunder, precious Lord, hear my cry. Keep me safe till the storm passes by. Till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand, and keep me safe till the storm passes by. Many times Satan whispers, there is no need to try, for there's no end of sorrow, there's no hope by and by. But I know that thou art with me, and tomorrow I'll rise where the storms never darken the sky. Storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand, and keep me safe till the storm passes by. When the long night has ended and the storms come no more,
Let me stand in thy presence on that bright, peaceful shore, in that land where the tempest never comes. Lord, may I dwell with thee till the storm passes by, till the storm passes over, till the thunder sounds no more, till the clouds roll forever from the sky. Hold me fast, let me stand in the hollow of thy hand, and keep me safe till the storm passes by. Just keep me safe till the storm passes by.
Psalm 116:15 says, precious in the sight of the Lord is the death of his saint. You see, last Thursday morning, Edith took her last breath here on earth and took her first breath in heaven. You see, that was precious because Edith was ready to go. She was ushered from this old life, this old world, with all the troubles and trials of this old world. And Edith kept up with everything. She watched the news, and she kept up with the coronavirus, and she kept up with the economy and the presidential situation. She kept up with all of it. But she was ushered from this old life into the arms of Jesus, into the precious arms of Jesus. Edith was a beautiful lady inside and out. I've known Edith for over 50 years. She often reminded me that she remembered the first time I sang a solo at Barnhart Baptist Church when I was 6 years old. And she always said, I can remember you little fellas standing up there, but she couldn't say that in later years that I was a little fella, but she remembered when I was a little fella singing. But Edith was one of 13 children, and she had a loving and caring family. She loved all of her brothers and sisters so much, and she was raised on a tobacco farm in Holliston. She went to Holliston High School. Perry's family and her family owned farms where Bernard's Landing is today. I met with Edith about 5 years ago, and she said, she had told me before she wanted me to preach her funeral. She said, I want you to come over and I want to talk with you and tell you what I want you to say at my funeral. And I said, okay. So Renee and I went over and we spent a couple hours with her, and she was going over different things, her childhood, and it was just very interesting to me, her upbringing, her family, and everything. But they had farms where Bernard's Landing is today. And she loved spending time with her grandparents at their farm. And their farm is where Smith Mountain Lake Dam is today. And about two years ago, I guess, David, Edith asked me, she said, have you ever been to the dam? And I said, no, that's one place I've never been. She says, well, I'm going to take you. But what she really meant was I was going to take her. But so Renee and I and David and Edith went to the dam that day, and I had never seen the dam. And so it was so interesting. She was pointing out this is where so-and-so lived, and this was where my grandmother's farm was. And it was just very interesting. We had such a great day that day. We stopped and had lunch. It was just a wonderful day of spending time with David and Edith and learning all about her family. It was just a great time, and she just loved and enjoyed telling us all about where her family lived and about the lake coming in and taking their property and all that. But she loved her family, she loved her upbringing. And Edith was 15 years old when she left home. She moved in with her sister, and she went to work at Burlington Mills. She worked on a loom, and then later she was an inspector of the cloth. And listen to this. Her first job, she earned 54 cents an hour. 54 cents an hour. Edith was a hard worker. Her and Perry had known each other for many years because their farms joined. And so she started dating Perry in 1945. And after she started dating him, a week later, they were married. They ran off to North Carolina and got married. She was 19 and Perry was 25. And they were married for 55 and a half years. They lived in Norfolk for a while and then in Franklin County and then to Roanoke City and then to Bedford County. Then Edith moved back to Vinton after Perry passed away, and then her last for several years she was at Elm Park Estates. And Edith worked hard. She raised three children. They were her pride and her joy. And she went back to work in the 1970s and worked until 1991 in Miller and Rhodes. And after the retirement, she volunteered at Roanoke Memorial Hospital for many, many years. She loved that. She loved being around people. And she loved being a hostess or whatever you call it there at Roanoke Memorial. She loved volunteering and helping families and situations. Now, I mentioned that Edith was beautiful inside and out. Now, Edith loved beautiful clothes. I think everyone here that knew her knew that. She loved beautiful clothes. She loved beautiful jewelry that matched her clothes. And when she came to church or anywhere, she looked perfect. And that was the way Edith was. She was a beautiful lady inside and out. She had the love of the Lord in her heart, but yet she loved people and she loved her the way she looked. And she was proud of that. I remember years ago, she loved Cadillacs, by the way. And one of the things that she requested today was the hearse be a Cadillac. And the hearse today is a Cadillac sitting out there. It's going to take her to the cemetery. But I remember years ago that Perry and Edith bought a yellow Cadillac. Y'all remember that yellow Cadillac, some of y'all? Well, the first Sunday they drove that Cadillac to church, Edith and Perry got out of that car, and they looked like a king and queen. Edith had on a beautiful yellow suit, and Perry had on a beautiful yellow sport coat. They matched that yellow Cadillac, and they came in church. When you saw them together, were at church or anywhere, they were dressed alike. Now, I don't think Perry had a whole lot to say about that. Because Perry had every color sport coat you can imagine. If Edith had on a pink dress, he had on a pink sport coat, you know. And this was the picture of their 50th wedding anniversary, and she dressed him in royal blue, and she wanted to be in royal blue. But they had outfits that matched. Now, I don't know if you know this or not, but Edith would tell you what's on her mind. And she didn't mind you telling her back what's on your mind, too. But when I first started wearing this goatee, she came to church one Sunday and she said, "That looks awful on you. Why are you having that on?" And she says, "It looks awful and also it's three different colors." And I said to Edith, I said, "Well, your hair's three different colors too." And she just looked at me and shook her head. But Edith loved, she didn't mind. I guess when you're almost 95 years old, you can get away with telling anybody what you want to tell them. So I can't imagine what she's told the family through the years, you know. And we don't want to hear that, but anyway. But anyway, Edith loved to look pretty. And I know she used to say when she worked at Miller and Rhodes that she would wait till something was on sale and she would buy her something, then she would buy Perry something to match it. And they were a beautiful couple together. 55 years they were together. Edith and Perry loved to travel. They traveled all over the world, all 50 states, six different countries, and she loved to travel. 25 years ago, when they started coming to Mineral Springs, they started traveling with our Senior Saints group. And we were on a trip in Kentucky one time, and we were in a little town, and everybody was going to eat lunch on their own. So Renee and I ended up eating lunch with Edith and Perry that day. And they told us, well, Edith told us. She didn't let Perry talk a whole lot, you know. But Edith told us about all their travels and how much fun they had had and where all they had been and how wonderful it was. And they loved seeing different things. And she loved eating at new restaurants and trying new things. And she just had a wonderful time traveling. And she traveled with our senior adults up until about 2 years ago. I think her and David and Frank and Jane went on a day trip with us to the Woodford House to see a show. And she loved traveling and she missed traveling. She went on cruises with us. She loved going on cruises. She went with us up to New England. She went with us to Branson. She just loved going and having a good time. She was a people person. She loved traveling. She loved watching movies on the bus. And I remember showing, we was going on a cruise one night and we were showing a movie about a football player. Well, Edith loves sports. And all of you grandchildren, you know she was at all of your ball games. If you were having a ball game, she was going to be there to watch you all play. She loved sports. And after that movie was over, she just started clapping and clapping and clapping. And, you know, and no one else clapped, but she thought it was a wonderful movie because it was about football and sports, you know. And but she loved having a good time. She loved to play Rook. Her and David and my mom and dad and Betty and Ray Woods, they played Rook every week together. Now, Edith was very competitive. She wanted to win. And if someone didn't play something exactly right, she would throw her cards in to say, we're going to play this one over again. And so they would have to deal and play over again. But they had a lot of wonderful years playing Rook together. She loved playing cards. But she was out to win, very competitive. You see, Edith was ready to leave this world. I had talked with her right before we left to go on a trip last week, and I said, can I pray with you, Edith, before I leave, before I go? And she said, you sure can. You know you can. She said, I always love you praying with me. And the last word she ever spoke to me was, I love you. And she meant that. She was a prayer warrior. She prayed for us. She prayed for our church. She prayed for our pastors. She prayed for her friends and her family. She was a prayer warrior. She loved you all. Edith was prepared for her death. She told me many times that she was ready to go. Over these last couple of months, she said to me, she says, I don't know if I'm going to pull through this or not. She says, but it's okay. She says, it's okay. I'm ready to go. She says, I know where I'm going. I'm going to be with the Lord. I want to read this passage in John chapter 14. Jesus is speaking to his disciples, and they're concerned or maybe worried about their future. There may be some of you here today that may be concerned or worried about your future. May you find comfort and answers in these words from Jesus as the disciples did. Jesus said, let not your heart be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself, that where I am, there you may be also. And whither I go, ye know, and the way ye know. Thomas said unto the Lord, we don't know how thou goest, and how can we know the way? Jesus said unto him, I am the way, I am the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. Edith knew the Lord. She knew the way. She knew the truth. Edith was raised in Minto Baptist Church. And at age 13, she asked Jesus Christ into her heart to be her Lord and Savior. And I was thinking about, she was 13. So 81 years, Edith has been a Christian. Isn't that amazing? Many, many people never lived to be 81. But she was a Christian for 81 years. She realized that Jesus was the only way. She realized that Jesus was the truth. She told me that she got saved at a meeting and dinner on the grounds, an all-day meeting and dinner on the grounds. Y'all remember those times when you used to have those? She got saved that day. She realized she was lost and needed a Savior. You see, there's only one way to be saved. It's not by being good. It's not by helping people. It's not by giving money to people or attending church, although those are great, and Edith did all those. But that's not why she's in heaven today. She's in heaven today because she realized that she was a sinner and she needed Jesus, and she asked Jesus to come into her heart to be her Lord and Savior. She realized that she could not save herself. Only through the shed blood of Jesus Christ there on Calvary's cross, and by trusting in Him, she would make her way to heaven. We prepare for many things in life. We prepare for trips, retirement, work days. Ladies prepare for meals. But are we prepared for our life here on earth to end? Edith had no idea that last Thursday morning at 9:40, she was going to take her last breath. But you know what? She was prepared. If our last breath would be this evening, would we be prepared as she would? Would we be prepared to spend eternity with our Lord Jesus Christ in heaven? Edith served the Lord faithfully. She was involved in early court for many years, and then she moved to Bedford County. They started attending Barnhart Baptist Church, where they went for 34 years. And then for the last 25 years or more, they started attending Mineral Springs Baptist Church, and it was a great honor to be one of her pastors all those years. I grew up with them in Barnhart, and then one day, her coming to Barnhart, that I could be one of her pastors, and I loved being one of her pastors. I loved loving on her and being there for her. She was a member of the Willing Worker Sunday School class, and she loved to sing. She sang in our sanctuary choir and was very active in our senior saints ministry. She sang in our senior adult choir, and our senior adult choir sang in nursing homes and other churches, and she loved doing that. She loved ministering to other people. And then after she got where she had to move to Elm Park, she would come back to church some. David would go and get her, bring her back to church some, and then she got where she wasn't able to come back to church, but she loved the church, and she prayed for the church, and she would always tell me, I'm praying for the church, I'm praying for the people, I'm praying for the pastors, and she said, I love the church. And she loved how David took care of her. David, for 19 years, took care of her. He would go and get her, especially when she moved to Elm Park, he would go and get her and take her out for lunch or take her out for a long drive, even during COVID. After the quarantine was up there at Elm Park, he would go and get her, and they would go for long drives, and he would go in the restaurant and get her a meal and bring it back out to her car so she could enjoy getting out. I know it was lonesome there for a long time where she had to stay in her room. It was really hard for her, but she enjoyed the 19 years that you all had together, David. You were a blessing to her. Edith was a prayer warrior. She prayed for people. She wanted to know who was sick and who was not sick, how they were. You know, when I would talk to her, she would ask about all the people in the church and ask how they were doing. And she said, I've been praying for them. She was a prayer warrior. When I went to Bible college, I'm not going to tell you how many years ago that was, but anyway, Edith prayed for me. And about every month, I would get a letter from Edith in the mail with a $20 bill in it. And back in those days, a $20 bill was a whole lot of money. But she loved, because I was going into the ministry, and she loved to pray for me and support me, and she did that for many, many years. That's the type of person she was. She was a caring and loving person. Edith loved her family. She loved her kids, her grandchildren, her siblings. She loved each of you, and she was proud of all of you. She talked about you. I remember when she moved to Elm Park, and the first time I went to see her, she said, now, my daughter-in-law's decorated this whole apartment. She said, they put everything, and she said, doesn't it look beautiful? She said, it's beautiful. And they've taken care of everything back at Feather Gardens and for the sale of everything, and she says, they have been so good to me to take care of me. So she appreciated everything y'all did for her. And she loved you for it, and she loved y'all taking care of her. Edith told me, as hard as it was to lose Perry, and I was with her the day Perry passed away. We were all at the hospital room that day, and we were standing around his bed, and they were going to have to make a decision whether to unhook him from life support or not. But before they unhooked him from life support, God took him, and she didn't have to make that decision. I was standing with her, right beside her, holding her hand when Perry left this world, went to be with Jesus. And it was so hard for her. She cried. She loved Perry so much. He was the light of her life. She called him Dumplin', I believe. But as hard as that was for her, she said the hardest thing that she's ever gone through in life was losing her daughter, Gloria. She said, it's not right for a mother to outlive her child. She loved Gloria with all her heart. And she took care of Gloria. And it was hard for Edith, but she would push her in that wheelchair, and she would go to see her in Rocky Mountain when she was there. And she went out of her way to take care of Gloria. And when Gloria struggled so much, and Edith struggled right along with her to take care of her. But when Gloria passed away, it was kind of bittersweet because it was so hard to lose her. But she had peace because her suffering was over and that she was with the Lord. When Lloyd contacted me on Thursday morning, my first thoughts when he told me that Edith had passed away, my first thoughts was that Edith is with Perry and Gloria now, And what a great reunion they're having in heaven together. I want to encourage you today, when you remember Edith, remember how much she loved you all. How much she enjoyed and loved life for almost 95 years. She'd been 95 next month. She enjoyed life and she lived life to its fullest. But most of all, I want you to remember about Edith, how she loved and trusted in the Lord. She trusted in Him as her Lord and Savior. And I think she would have me ask you today, do you trust in Him? Do you know Him as your Lord and Savior? Edith has left for us an example. She has left a great example for us to follow. She lived a wonderful life. She loved the Lord. She served the Lord faithfully. And she would have you to trust in the Lord and turn to Him and one day be reunited with her in heaven. Let's all pray together. Our precious Heavenly Father, we again thank You for this day. We thank You, Lord, for Edith's life. We thank You for what an example she has left us. Lord, 95 years, she has served You. She has loved You. Father, she has loved her family, her grandchildren. Lord, she loved David. And Lord, I know that Mabel Wheeler is struggling today because she's lost one of her best friends. And I pray, Lord, You would comfort her. And Lord, I just thank You for Edith's life. And Lord, as we think about Edith, may we remember Edith with a smile on our face. May we pray for this precious family. Lord, I know it's going to be a void in their life. They're going to be missing their mom and their grandmother and their mother-in-law. I pray for the siblings. Lord, they were all so close and they loved each other so much. And I pray, Lord, You would comfort them. May they rely upon You. Lord, I pray most of all, if there's someone here today that doesn't know You as our Lord and Savior, I pray they would trust in You, turn to You, Lord, because Your word tells us that it's appointed upon each of us to die, and after that, the judgment. Lord, help us to search our hearts and lives today to make sure that we know You and that You're our Lord and Savior. I thank You again for Edith's life, and Lord, we'll miss her, but Lord, we know that she's in peace, she's breathing freely, and Lord, she's walking on streets of gold. And we thank You for her life. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. And the closing song today was another one of Edith's favorite songs, When We All Get to Heaven.